Good morning, children. Welcome to this session today. Well, coming to this session, today we are going to discuss about the miscellaneous exercise sums. If you see in miscellaneous exercise sums, this one, find the area of the region bounded by the line y is equal to 3x plus 2 and x axis and the ordinates x equal to minus 1 and 1. See, these questions already we have learned. These are very simple ones. These are very simple ones. Okay, anyhow. I used to tell you the 3 points to remember. Number 1 point, how to plot it. Number 2, finding the limits. Number 3, using appropriate formula. These 3 things keep in your mind. Okay, now, so I'm going to do the first graph. Just look at it carefully. See, y is equal to 3x plus 2. Y is equal to 3x plus 2, put x value 0 on y value 0. So if x equal to 0, y value 2, y value 0, x value minus 2/3. Right. So using this data, I'm going to plot the graph. Now, y is equal to 3x plus 2, say the points 0, 2. And minus 2/3, 0. So this one minus 2/3, 0. And let us assume this point is 2, so 0, 2. Okay. Now if you are plotting, this will be the number line. Right. Now he said clearly between the limits, between the ordinates minus 1 and 1. Okay. Now at minus 1, substitute. If suppose x equal to minus 1, what happens? X equal to minus 1, you write it. So if x equal to minus 1, y is equal to 3 into minus 1 plus 2. So which is minus 3 plus 2, minus 1. So the point is minus 1, minus 1. So it is minus 1. You can draw here. This is a point. Similarly, if x equal to 1, write in that. If x equal to 1, it is 5. So at 1, you take it 1. And go, this point is 1, 5, and this point which we got it -1, -1. Now the question is, we need to find the area under this. So what is this line? Y is equal to 3x plus 2, this line. Okay, now we have to find the area of the shaded region. So what is the shaded region? Here I'm drawing, see. This is the shaded region. Okay, if you see the graph clearly, some part is below the x-axis and some part is above the x-axis. Okay, so we are thorough now. Where it is intersecting the x-axis, where it is intersecting the y-axis, everything we got it. Now, with respect to x-axis, with respect to y-axis, now you decide it. So now I'm taking actually with respect to x-axis. So when I'm taking with respect to x-axis, now I want to find the area of the shaded region. So area, required area is equal to if you see the limits, minus 1 to here. What are the limits? Minus 1 to minus 2/3. Minus 1 to minus 2/3. And let us assume this is y1. And below the x-axis. So I'm going to take it modulus for this. Or here also you can take it modulus y1. I can take it like this also. Plus 1 to, sorry, minus 2/3 to 1 y2 dx. Minus 2/3 to 1 2 dx. Okay, see, modulus y1 here, there is no modulus. So let us take here total modulus. If you take the modulus, see why we are taking the modulus, already I explained you, because when you are taking below the x-axis, it will be considered as a negative. So area should not be negative. So if you apply the modulus, it comes to plus. Now integration minus 1 to minus 2/3, which is 3x plus 2 dx, plus integration minus 2/3 to 1, same thing, 3x plus 2 dx, because with the same line only, with respect to the same line only, it is going to be happen. So that's why y1 and y2 will be the same. Now do the integration for this. 3x square by 2 plus 2x, and apply the limits minus 1 to minus 2 by 3. Same way, 3x square by 2 plus 2x, what you could write, minus 2 by 3 to 1. Now we are supposed to substitute the upper limit followed by the lower limit. So let me substitute that all. Right. If you substitute upper limit first, so it is happening 3 by 2 first, 3 by 2 and x square. So what you can write it, minus 2 by 3 whole square plus 2 into minus 2 by 3. First part of this one over, followed by minus into, then 3 by 2 minus 1 whole square plus 2 into minus 1 plus, now 1 you write it first. What you can write? 3 by 2 into 1 whole square plus 2 into 1 minus, then minus 2 by 3 write it, same way. So if you write minus 2 by 3, 3 by 2 into minus 2 by 3 whole square plus 2 into minus 2 by 3. Okay, so let us simplify this now. Okay, now if you see on the board, it is 3 by 2 into minus 2 by 3 whole square plus 2 into minus 2 by 3. So apply the first upper limit followed by the lower limit. Modulus, don't forget the modulus. In case if you do not apply the modulus, you will get the answer as 0. So you are supposed to apply the modulus, then you have to continue. Okay, then modulus, then this one, 3 by 2 into 4 by 9 minus 4 by 3, then this one, minus 3 by 2 plus 2. So modulus plus, next one, no need of modulus. So it is 3 by 2 plus 2 minus 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3, because minus is here, and plus 4 by 3. Okay, so now this is our simplification. Directly I am writing the answer here. If you simplify, you will get it as 1 by 6 plus this answer will be 25 by 6, totally 26 by 6, which is 13 by 3 square units. 13 by 3 square units. This completes the solution.